I am Nancy Nightingale of roll number 26, and my fellow teammates are K. Bulakshmi of roll number 9 and S. Arna of roll number 21. We are from BTech final year and we are batch number 1. Our project guide is Dr. Praveen Babu Chopala sir, and our project title is Digital Color Image Denoising Using Vector Median Filters.
Okay. In your topic, you have mentioned that you are eliminating the impulse noise.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell the difference between the salt paper noise and the impulse noise in visibility?
Yes, sir. Salt paper is also called as impulse noise. Both the noises are same. And in visibility, the impulse noise chooses the component randomly, and it can correct an image component randomly, and also the pixel value to another extent value, which that is also chosen randomly. The visibility of an impulse noise image will be like color component dots.
Okay. If it is a black dots, it's a paper noise, and if it is white dots, it's a salt noise.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you remove any impulse noise just created by an other source?
So we worked on impulse noise, and we examined on Gaussian noise also, and we somewhat removed the Gaussian noise too.
Okay. Bullish me?
Sir.
Can you make tell the difference between the impulse noise and Gaussian noise?
Impulse noise is a one device to another device ni noise pampinchinappudu impulse noise untadi sir. Gaussian noise drop ayinappudu noise.
By seeing an image, can you differ that it is it contains of impulse noise or Gaussian noise?
Yes.
Bullish me.
Sir.
Can you define the noise name by seeing a image? It contains an impulse noise or Gaussian noise, so that we can apply that algorithm to that image. How will be the appearance of a Gaussian noise in the image? As mentioned by Nancy, that impulse noise consists of an color dots. Okay, back to Aruna. Aruna, can you define the difference between the Gaussian noise and impulse noise in appearance in the image? Arna, unmute the system, your phone. Arna, unmute your phone.
Hi, sir.
And tell me the difference between the impulse noise and Gaussian noise in appearance of an image.
Impulse noise.
I've been defined by Nancy already. It contains and color dots on the image. What about Gaussian noise?
Probability distribution.
Okay. Can you eliminate impulse noise in any image?
sir?
We get one image through mail or something. Yes. In that we have been seen that there is an impulse noise. Can you remove that impulse noise by using your software?
Yes, sir.
What about Gaussian noise? At least, what is the appearance of Gaussian noise? Back to Nancy. Nancy.
Yes, sir.
Can you define finally? How is the appearance of Gaussian noise in the image?
So the Gaussian noise generated by probability density function, and from the probability density function, the random values will be taken, and it Gaussian noise limits a range of suppose -3 to 3. In a graph, it will be like a single peak length, and it will be in a limit, and the Gaussian noise visibility like gray dots.
Good. You can eliminate the Gaussian noise and impulse noise in the image which was sent by someone.
Yes, we examined on Gaussian noise also.
Okay, thank you.
Conclude
this. Conclusion.
Thank you, sir.
And all the best for your future.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Neeraja, chepoma.
Good morning, everyone.
Yeah, please, Neeraja. Please, good morning, and to good morning to all your batch. Please give a brief introduction to your project.
Yeah, our project title is Speed Locking System Using Fingerprint Technology. Our project guide is Mr. Sonraju sir. Our teammates are V. Purnima, G. Kiran, and D. Manikanta Mohan.
These numbers.
Coming to our project. Register V. Purnima. Register number is 27. G. Kiran, register number is 5. And D. Manikanta Mohan, register number is 31. And my register number is 23.
Yes. Okay, I have two questions for you, Neeraja.
Okay, sir.
So, in your video, we have seen your video. And I congratulate you for making a very nice video presentation of your project.
Thank you, sir.
And I liked your video. Very nice. I have two questions. You said that the drawback of the existing speed locking system is that it's very expensive and yes, can sir. Be controlled at will. So you said those are the two problems in existing speed locking systems.
Yes,
so how expensive is the existing speed locking system?
Sir, because they are using more number of sensors, sir, and existing systems like automatic controlling system using multiple sensors, in that system they are using ultrasonic sensors and eye blink sensors, and in some other existing systems they are using alcohol sensors and more number of sensors, sir, and other more number of sensors, so the cost is expensive.
How much?
I don't know, sir.
So if you were to commercialize your project, at what cost can you develop a full-scale fingerprint technology-based speed logging system?
$5,000 to $6,000, sir.
Okay, good. And you also said that you can control, anybody can control the existing systems at their own will. How is it possible that anybody can control at their own will? I think only a mechanic or a manufacturer can do that, right?
Sir.
What do you mean by your statement that anybody can control at their own will?
Yes, in our system we are using fingerprint sensor, so only one person can change it. In that existing systems, there is no such system, like fingerprint.
Okay.
So they can increase.
And it can change it. That's what you mean.
Yes, sir.
Okay. My second question to you is, in your block diagram, if you remember your block diagram, there is a MQ3 sensor connected toward the Arduino system. So now what is this MQ3 sensor? What does it sense and how does it operate?
Sir, we are using that for alcohol detection, sir.
Why do you want to use an alcohol detector in a...
Activity of the sensor will increase. And we have used a buzzer. Whenever the conductivity of sensor increases, then the microcontroller will make the buzzer indicate, sir.
Okay. Purnima.
Yes, sir.
Are you there?
Yes, sir.
I have only one question for you, Purnima.
Okay, sir.
Can you explain the full block diagram of your project and its operation? Lohit, sir, okay, can you put that on screen? The block, their presentation slides.
Which makes that two terminals in the bike will get short. Sir, in the bike, when ignition key, we are having two wires, sir. When the key is unlocked, the two wires get open, then the bike will start. If we are automatically, the two wires will get short, then automatically the bike will get slow, sir.
Okay, got
that
your
is point. Controlling the project.
Yeah, got your point. My last question to you is the system, sir, that you've developed, can it control speed only in bikes or also in cars, aeroplanes, trains, etc.?
Sir, cars lo kuda control cheyachu.
Trains,
sir, but only in bike technique we are only having that wires concept, sir.
Okay.
But not only car. Yes, sir.
Good. So very well presented, all of you. I appreciate all of you for your presentation, and also for thank you for coming and participating in the world. And I wish you all the best, and I wish you all the best in your careers also. Thank you very much. You can log off. Your teammates and announce the title.
Okay. Good morning to everyone. I'm Sihir Saijanti from Batch 3. Our title is A Voice Control Pick and Place Robot Using Android Application. Our project head is Mr. Bhai Pradeep Kumar, sir, ME, PhD, Assistant Professor at ECE Department. Our team members are G. Pushpanjali, SDL Saiti, and N. Shiva.
Okay, Jansi, I have two questions for you.
Yes, sir.
You, in your video, in your presentation, you said the data transmission rate in existing pick and place robotic systems is very low. So how low is the data transmission rate? And what is the data transmission rate in your system?
Yes, sir. In existing system, the data transmission is only 10 meters, sir. The range is only 10 meters. And in our system, it is extended up to 30 meters, sir.
Okay. Are there any pick and place robots currently being used in the industry?
Yes, sir, but they use it. Sir?
Yeah, can you answer?
Yes, sir.
Are there any existing pick and place robots being used in the industry?
Yes, sir, there are some systems using Zigbee technology, and Zigbee technology, sir, but it is of low, very low transmission rate, sir. It's a very disadvantage in the, it's manual operated, sir. But our is voice command, our we can operate our voice command, sir.
Okay, your voice has been, you have stopped speaking, Krishmanjali.
Continue, sir. Continue.
Sir, interesting, sir.
Yeah.
Please don't stop.
Krishmanjali, continue.
Yes, sir.
No problem, continue.
Finally, four motors are, first motor forward backward and second motor right left and third motor upward backward and fourth open close. Finally, according to motor action to sir.
Okay. Sai Jansi. Can you please explain the block diagram of your project once?
Sir, first we have to pair our Bluetooth Android application with Bluetooth, sir. We are using Arduino voice control app to pair with the Bluetooth. First, power supply is given to the respective components. First, we have to install the app and we have to give command through the our app using Android. Whenever a command is given to the Android phone, the signal is sent to the Bluetooth receiver unit. That signal is given to the Arduino UNO. That Arduino UNO compares the received signal with the program installed in it. Whenever a signal is received is in the program of Arduino, then the Arduino controls according to the program we have written in our Arduino UNO. And the motor moves according to it. For example, a forward command is given at the Android application. It is sent to the Bluetooth receiver unit. Then the Bluetooth receiver unit sends the signal to the Arduino UNO. Then Arduino UNO starts the vehicle driver unit and the robot moves in forward direction when a voice command is given through the Android application.
Okay, good. So, well done. Thank you very much for participating in this Viva.
Thank you, sir.
I wish you all the best and I wish you all the best in your career also. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now you good can morning start to
Okay, sir. Good morning to respected sirs and madam. This is Malika and our batch number is 4. My team members' names were Neelma Shetty, K. Tanuja, Lakshmi Prasanna, and our batch guy name is Mr. B. Harikumar, sir, assistant professor of EC department. And the title aim of our project is transmission of voice through optical fiber communication. Introduction of optical fiber communication. Transferring of data. First of all, what we have to know what is meant by communication. Transferring of data from one place to another place is known as communication. We have the voice. There are four types of data. There are four types of data, and those were voice, text, image, and video. We have to voice and the and the media we use this optical fiber communication. Next, handling to Prasanna sir.
Prasanna, unmute.
Prasanna, please unmute yourself and
yes. Good morning, sir. Here basically telecommunication we are going with telecommunication block diagram. The block diagram mainly consists of two sections.
Please ask the question.
Okay. Okay, sir. Come to Lakshmashna.
Yes.
In your project, you have been mentioned as there are two lines. One is of an copper wire and is of an optical fiber line for communication.
Yes, sir.
Which one is more advantageous? Why?
Optical fiber is more advantage than copper, sir, because copper have certain limit. The data cannot be transferred to long distance and errors will be occurred during the transmission of data. But in optical fiber cable, we will not have those disturbances, and the data will be transmitted very clearly. And for copper cable, we have to set up an exchange within an area of 5 kilometers. Otherwise, the data can't be reached clearly to the receiver. Whereas the optical fiber does not need any setup.
Okay, Tanuja. Tanuja.
Yes, sir.
Amit. What is the speed? Transmission is good in, sir, copper or optical fiber? In which transmission speed of communication is good, whether in copper wire communication or optical fiber communication? The
sir,
speed.
Optical fiber only good. The speed is good in optical fiber only, sir, compared to in a copper, as we already know that copper can 10 kilometers. And it can extend 8 kilometers, but when we compare to the optical fiber, it can go longer than the copper, sir.
Okay. That means we have to replace all the existing system which was in BSNL exchange with an optical fiber.
Yes, sir. And when we compare with copper, optical fiber main division have less pairs of exchange, less pairs connected in the exchange, sir, and it will be easier to transform communication compared to the copper, sir, because copper exchange is more longer and with connecting more connection, I mean 5,000 connections, sir.
Is there a limit for copper?
Yes, sir, there is a limit for copper, and we can connect only 4,000 connections, sir. In our BSNL, we are connecting only 4,000, sir. But when we compare to an optical fiber, we can connect how many connections we want.
Okay. Name city. Unmute once.
Yes, sir.
Compared to a wire communication and a wireless communication.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Wire communication and wireless communication, which one is good?
Sir, it depends on user's exchange, but comparing in between them, the wireless communication is more accurate. Why? Because while communicating with this cable, like in BSNL, we studied like while connecting with cables, when the digging process was occurs by some areas, there is a chances of losses of data. Hence, we should have to replace the cables again. But while comparing with the wireless communication, from system only we can operate the signals, and we can even modulate in by some techniques. In now, some more techniques are using to. Like as we studied in our data also, by using CNC cellular mobile communication system, we can control the traffic, air traffic, by using handoff techniques. So we can say that wireless communication is more better than guided communication.
Okay, then why you are going for an optical fiber communication? As you know that wireless communication is good.
But while transmitting data for longer distance, there is a lossage of data. We should have to use the carrier signal at very high frequencies. But coming to the OFC, we can even you like the data is transferred in the form of light. The speed of light is very more, like 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. Hence, we can transfer the data in very less time of time. Hence, we are going through OFC only. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. I want to say one thing, that if there is a wireless communication, we have to use optical fiber communication also, because wireless communication is a plan B, where the communication connection will be done by an optical fiber only. If it is fails, then we can connect for a wireless communication. Okay, when we talk with cell phone near to a tower, there is occurrence of a wireless communication. While we talking with a landline phone, it will be connected in an optical fiber communication, isn't it? And we are using an internet now, broadband internet. This will be done by an optical fiber only. Okay, wireless is a plan B option. Okay.
Yes.
And Monica. Monica.
Sir.
Conclude a project.
Hence in a project we concluded that data transmission is through OFC is more accurate than copper. Is more accurate sir?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, you can continue, Malika, no problem.
Okay.
Data transmission is more safe and accurate than copper, because copper is only to 5 to 8 kilometers. If the line is crossed than 5 to 8 kilometers, it may be some noises be occurred, sir. Then OFC is more accurate than copper, sir.
Okay. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
I wish you all the best for your career.
Thank you.
Okay, Trinath, congratulations for your video presentation. You have done a very nice video.
Thank you, sir.
400 views, fantastic.
Thank you, sir.
So you have a lot of support and there are many people who like your work. So congratulations to your team and also to your project guide. Very nice work. So we have seen your video. Especially your slide at 3 minutes 54 seconds. There is an ambulance stuck in the traffic and there is an ambulance racing towards its destination. So you have very well described the impact of your work through those two pictures. I like your pictures very much. So as a team leader, Mr. Trinath, can you please announce the title of your project and introduce your team members?
Yes, sir. Good morning to everyone. This is Srinath Kumar, and our project guide Ram Babu sir, and our project team members Sriram Chaitanya, Namata Harini, and Dinesh Kumar. And our project title is ambulance traffic and patient monitoring system. And the main aim of our project is to clear the traffic at traffic junctions to the ambulance and to give information before reaching the hospital of the patient, so that we can decrease the death rate in the society. It is very useful to our society. Thank you.
Okay, Trinath. My question to you is, of course, you have given priority to ambulances. That is the basic point in your project. Now, as far as your block diagram goes, there is a control switch in your ambulance or a push button that the driver has to press when he is stuck in traffic. Now, instead of giving the control to the driver of the ambulance, why don't you automate it by having an ambulance detection system in the traffic light system itself. Did you think about it?
No, sir. Just it is a prototype, sir. We are thinking to do starting system. I mean, if it is executed, then we will later we will go on advanced versions.
Okay. Is there currently any system being used to give priority to ambulances?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. There is no. In other countries there is a priority to that ambulance, but there is no priority for ambulance in India, sir. So that we are saying that, yes sir.
Okay, very nice. So are you writing a paper on this, because you say there is no work in this area, especially in India?
Yes, sir, we have completed that paper publication, and their acceptance was done in that publication. But it is in the process, sir. We submitted to that publications. I mean, we are requested to publish our paper in the website, but acceptance was done.
Okay.
It is in the payment process.
What is the journal?
Very good. Very good.
Sir,
what is the journal name?
Journal name IJIT. I mean, I don't know the full name of that.
IJIT.
It is a Scopus journal.
No, sir. Up to now, it is a Scopus journal, but there is no Scopus, so that we are waiting for that Scopus journal.
Okay. Try to publish it in UGC approved journal. Try to publish in UGC approved journals.
Okay, sir.
Okay, Dinesh.
Yes, sir.
Good morning, sir. Hello.
Please unmute yourself, sir.
Dinesh?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
What type of device are we using to send the information from an ambulance to hospital?
Sir, GSM module, sir. We are using GSM module to send the message from the ambulance to the hospital, sir.
Okay. What type of information can you send at present in your project?
Sir, patient heartbeat and the blood group. And body temperature of the patient will be sent to the ambulance to the hospital, sir, by GSM.
Okay. That will be received by the hospital team.
Yes, sir. Hospital team will pre-prepare about the patient, sir.
Okay. They prepare for the requirement for the operation.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Namrata?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. What is the extension of your project in future?
It is useful to the patient, sir. That that the patient's life is very precious nowadays.
Okay.
But we are not having any facility that in India separate way for the ambulance like other countries, sir. We are modifying this system further.
Okay. Can you control the traffic system by your ambulance equipment?
No, sir. By only the ambulance driver can control the switches to clear the ambulance.
Okay. But this will be done by manually.
Yes, sir.
Okay, why can't we have to embed this for system? Because driver is in driving mode, he can't able to operate very fastly in the system, the switches or anything.
Yes, sir, but ambulance is stuck in the traffic means they can give the switches to indicate the traffic control team to clear that way.
Okay, as a government rule is there, while driving you do not operate any devices like cell phone or anything. So have to make that the equipment in the ambulance have to control the traffic system itself automatically. So that it will be helpful for a driver, isn't it?
Okay, sir.
Okay, Chaitanya. Chaitanya.
Sir.
Okay. Can you add this sugar levels information to sending data of an to the hospital?
Sir, it's in future scope, sir. We can also send it, sir.
Because it is also a basic parameter, because out of three there is a one sugar patient.
Yeah.
For this patient we have to deal differently while in operation. Okay.
Sir, but it's in future scope, sir.
Okay. If it is a burn accident, the skin is burn in a fire accident.
Okay, sir.
You have to add the parameter, you have to send the picture also to the hospital team so that they can know that the degree of level of burning of a skin and how they have been put some equipment or some medicines for the patient.
Okay. What type of
medicine to be used for an burning of a skin or burning of a flesh for a human being? It the image to be captured by a camera and have to send that image to an hospital team. Isn't it?
Okay, sir.
Yes, these are the features, future scope of the project.
Yeah.
Okay. Your project is very good and support this for the project for future and all the best for you.
Thank you,
to
sir.
To all the team.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, Murali, welcome.
Yes, good morning to respected sirs.
Good morning,
madam.
I have seen your project presentation video, very yes. Nice video.
Thank you, sir.
I think all your prototype and all your design is in the college, right?
Yes, sir.
That is why you could not do a very nice demonstration of the operation of your project.
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, you would have done much better, but still it is okay.
Okay.
We appreciate you and we will jump in. Can you please announce your title and introduce your project teammates? Yes, and Professor Suvarnaraju Garu will start with the Viva.
Yes, sir. Good morning to
please introduce sir. Yourself.
Yes, sir. My name is P. Murali Krishna and our project number is 6th batch and our title of our project is Early Eradication Warning System in Railways. And our project guide name is G. Manikanta, M.Tech, PhD, Wisdom College. And introducing our team members, P. Urmila Devi, registration number 31612951201, following P. I. Hamalata, 31612951206, and finally K. Pratima, 31612951201. Moving on to our project abstract, railways are the lifeline of.
Okay, it's okay. We will jump into Viva.
Viva.
Yes, sir.
Okay, where is the Urmila?
Sir, he is on.
Sir.
Okay.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. You have mentioned that the project title is Early Eradication and Warning System in Railways. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What type of obstacles or warnings can be given to an driver?
Sir, can I?
What type of warnings? That means from which sources? Fire accident, fire or level crossing?
Sir,
like that.
Our project our project give messages, obstacle detection, fire accidents, any track breakages or invisibility due to heavy fog also, it give messages to the loco pilots.
Okay. What type of sensor are being used for an crack detection?
Sir, we are not using any sensor for track detection, sir. We are using a continuity based loop equation, sir. Generally, current flows in a
closed system. Okay. Yes, explain that.
Yes. Generally, current flows in a closed loop. If any break happen, means it means no current flows through it. Similarly, we pass very small currents for the both left and right tracks. If any crack or damage, then it loop open. Then loop is broken. It means no current flows through. If we will get identification red signal in that.
Okay. Come to you, Urmila.
Sir.
What type of sensor have been used for an fog detection? Heavy fog detection.
Sir, we are not using any type of sensor, sir. It is manual, sir. The station master will sense a signal, sir. Why the signal is senses now? The master will identify whether the train is coming in our opposite direction or not. If any train is coming in our opposite direction, the master will give us the train is coming. He allows a red signal to stop. The signal is visible to the loco pilot, and the loco pilot will stop the train, sir.
Okay, it happens in the station or nearby station. If it is happen at middle of the two stations, who will give information? Hamma?
Sir?
The nearest morning will give the information.
Okay. I am saying that it will happen middle of the two stations, which are far away from the station. Who will give the information about the trains?
So the first station will say it's whether the train is coming out of the station.
Okay, what is the procedure to identify the obstacle on the track? Hama?
Sir,
the ultrasonic
sensor
is used in
there. Urmila, can you mute once? Hama will answer. Hamlata?
Sir?
Can you tell how you can avoid the accident, yes, if there is an obstacle on the track?
Hello? Sir?
Hello, Hama?
Sir, chappan, sir.
How do you identify the obstacle on the track?
The train will
As
be...
Said.
Sir, we are using obstacle purpose. We are using ultrasonic sensor, sir. And the ultrasonic sensor sending waves. When his obstacle was crossed the track, that time this wave is reflect to train. Reflect to the loco pilot, sir.
What is the range? Can obstacle can be detected by sensor?
Sir, break open sensors.
What is the range? Can the obstacle can be detected by the sensor?
Frequency range, sir.
No. Obstacle distance range. Distance.
70 meters.
17 meters.
70 meters, sir.
70 or 17.
Yes, sir. 70.
Can it control the speed of a train by the distance?
Yes, sir.
Okay, it can be implemented in our revenue system.
Sir?
Can we implement this sensors in our revenue system? It will work? In real mode?
Works, sir. It will work, sir.
Okay. Then publish a paper so that ISTS will know that and make an implementation.
Sir?
Publish a paper of your project so that the IS system will know that about a project and they implement the systems in the trains which reduces the accidents. Isn't it?
Yes.
Urmila?
Sir?
Can understand what I told?
Yes, sir.
If you publish a paper on a project, paper, okay. Tell Urmila.
Sir, but for demonstration purpose, we use range of sensors. But in real time, we use a long range distance ultrasonic sensor.
Okay. Well, the project has been good and to be implemented on railways to reduce our accidents so that all the people will reach safer to the destinations.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And thank you, okay, one and all, and all the best for the future.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome all of you for this Viva presentation. You have done a very good job with respect to the video presentation, and I also have followed your work during the reviews. Very nicely done. And today we will do our review. So the team leader Bhargav, can you please announce your title and introduce your team members?
Sure. Good morning to one and all. My name is Bhargav Raja from Batch 7. The title is Design Analysis of Low Power Efficiency GDI Balancing Multiplier by under the guidance of Vandana Madam. Now, my team members are Jyoti, Shanti, and Surya.
Okay. Bhargav, can you please explain in brief what your project is all about?
In past days, there are many multipliers are designed by their own purpose of merits and demerits are available. Now coming to the multipliers, there are some multipliers are best in speed, some are in areas are different levels of our operations. But our aim is to reducing in the some problems in the previous designs. Now I am taking the multiplier balancing multiplier and chosen. It is to best for some previous designs, but in we are taking the balancing multiplier. It has a high speed when compared to the all other multipliers. That's why we are choosing the multipliers to implement our project in balancing multiplier. But the small defect is happened. That is power consumption. We are choosing to rectify the power consumption in balancing multiplier. Now we have to implementing to recovering this operation. We are designing a hybrid balancing multiplier. This hybrid balancing multiplier has taken and implementing the design of balancing multiplier. The designing structure will be implemented using the Tanner tool software.
Okay, can you tell me what is the big difference between CMOS and GDI technologies?
Nothing
from your slides.
In CMOS, sir, we are using a PMOS and NMOS connected with the bulk, but the power supply and the connections will be connected and PN group, but every designing of adder and gates will connecting a power supply and ground very particular P and N as defined. But in the coming to the GDI technology, we have to connected a per own particular process. It will be given anyway to operated a power supply or grounded for your purpose of using for designing and or MUX or OR gate.
So what slide should we go to?
What, sir?
What is the slide number?
Slide number, sir. GDI technologies. Proposed design
difference slides. Between CMOS and GDI.
Sir, change in. Next. The structure comparisons.
That one.
Sir, previous one. Not done, sir. Previous. Comparison table is available, sir. Sir, change to side previous.
This one?
Up one.
This one?
Yes. This is the main comparison between GDI and CMOS, sir.
Yeah, so please explain to me what is the big difference between CMOS and GDI and which is better and why?
GDI is better, sir. I think because in the GDI technology, we have complexity of gating formation will be reduced by the changing of the positive and negative connections of what transistor, either P or N, it will be changed. But in the CMOS technology, we have defined a particular source, so it will be connected with a particular power supply of source, grounded vehicle, say, given to the in particular place. In P, coming to the PMOS, CMOS in P type, the power supply is given while it is activated, and the CMOS ground is required. But coming to the GDI, it is not mandatory. We have to change the conditions while doing the operation, what you have to done.
Okay. Can you explain the inverter? Where is the inverter? Where is the CMOS inverter in this slide? Oh, so, you don't have an inverter. Can you explain to me the OR gate in CMOS logic?
Yes,
when the input is 1-0.
By the input is 1-0, sir.
Yes.
The N place. Sir. By taking the sir, give me any two inputs.
1 and 0.
1 and 0. We are taking a 1 at A and a 0 at B. We are going to 1 at gate. The 1 goes to the in P type. It will be off and in P type. And it goes through that 0. And it will be P is open and 1 travels to the output.
Okay. Whereas for the GDI logic, so A is 1, so yes, PMOS, sir, will be on or off?
A is 1, PMOS is off, sir.
And NMOS will be on?
NMOS will be on, sir.
You have given a VDD.
Yes, sir.
To NMOS, VDD. So
Yes, sir, VDD. It will be given input of VDD means it one. The one travels to the output.
Okay. So when it is 0, 0, I want, can you please explain GDI logic or get 0, 0?
Repeat it. Sir, your voice will be stuck.
For a 0, 0, can you explain GDI logic?
For the 0, 0,
for input 0, 0.
Okay, sir. Input 0, 0.
Can you please explain OR gate logic in GDI?
Okay, sir. A will be 0. The P gate is activated, but B is also 0. The 0 travels to the output. A is 0. The AND gate will be off conditions. There is no input goes through the output. B is 0. The B output is goes to the output. So 0, 0, the output will comes 0.
Can you explain to me the difference between array multiplier and Wallace tree multiplier?
Array multiplier, it is only multiplied by the following of many rules and regulations. It will be followed by the throw of operation what we have required. It will be adds with the adders will commonly multiply. By coming to the valency multiplier, it will be reducing a technique by using the column compressions. If you have the incrementing of operation of the largest bits, it will be by designing the stages will be divided per particular one full adder to calculating the products.
Oh, can you go to the slides and explain from there? I want to actually see the difference. Please point out to the difference between the two multipliers.
So change slides. Starting.
This one?
No. I think you should go up.
So move forward. Up. Sir, up, sir. Up. Sir, pipe, sir.
Which one? Output terminal, no, this one? This one?
No, sir. Upwards, sir. No, sir. So I'm going to slide 7.
Slide 7.
Awesome. Yes, sir. The multiplier. Yes, sir. Okay, sir. So can I ask you?
Yes, please.
In array multiplier, the shifting of products is proper arrangement performed by simple routing, sir. And it doesn't require any logic.
So it is direct multiplication of the partial product. Sorry, direct summation of the partial products.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is the difference? What is a Wallace tree multiplier?
In Wallace tree multiplier, there is a problem difficulty in we will increasing the stages. The adding of the bits will be incremented, sir. That's why in the valency we have the Collins compression method is implemented in this.
No, can you actually go to the slide and explain to us, please?
Okay, sir. Next slide, please. After Vedic. Next slide, sir.
This one.
And that's one, sir.
Okay, so there is a bit of a difference in the circuitry. Can you explain what is the difference?
In the difference is, so we have evaporated the stages of multiplying bits. we are taking your 3-3 stages, that's required to one full adder can calculate the sum of carry and the products. It will be separated from these techniques. After that, all the sum and products will be finally calculated with the one full adder arrangement stage. That's why the complication will be decreasing in this multiplier.
So half adder, sorry, an array multiplier uses all half adders?
Yes, array multiplier can also use all half adders, but the half adders will be incremented, the stages of addition will be confused, what will take adding or separated from another.
Okay, so as far as I understand from your explanation, in the Wallace tree multiplier, you are compressing the columns by simply using sum and carry terms in the full adder. Other summation terms, is that correct?
Sir?
Okay.
I can't.
No, what I understand from your explanation is that in the Wallace tree multiplier, you compress the columns by using the sum and carry terms of the full adders in other full adders.
Full adders are structure is not changing, but the using of components will be reducing.
Okay, good. Jyoti. Jyoti, can you please unmute yourself? Jyoti.
Yes, sir.
I have one question for you. What is the use of adders in multipliers?
Adders are used to adding the numbers. It is a digital circuit, and it is used to add the binary numbers. We are having different types of adders: full adder, half adder. In full adder, we have 3 inputs. And half adder, we are using 2 inputs.
Okay, in a multiplier, what do you prefer to use, a half adder or a full adder?
In multipliers, we are using full adder and half adder, sir.
Why? Can't you do it off with all half adders or all full adders?
Sir, okay. In multipliers, we are using 2 inputs. We can use half adder. We can use 3 inputs. We can use full adder.
Okay. Shanti Begal. Is she there?
Sir, she is not connected to audio, sir. Audio and video.
Okay, Surya Kumar. Hello, Surya Kumar.
Sir. Hello.
I have one question for you. What is the need for low power in multipliers? Your project is all about low power multiplier design. What is the need for low power multiplier design?
Zero to five.
Can you be a bit loud and please speak quickly?
Zero to five. Hello?
Surya Kumar, I have asked you a question. What is the need for low power? What is the need to design low power multipliers?
Low power. GDI.
Jyoti, can you answer me? Hello, Jyoti. Is Jyoti not available?
Sir?
What is the need for designing low power multiplier circuits? Bhargav, can you answer me?
Yes, sir.
Please answer my question.
Lifespan of a processor will be increased, sir, by using the low power.
How?
Lifespan of a processor will be increased, sir.
How?
Yes, sir.
How can a lifespan of a processor increase by dissipating low power?
By confirming the low power, the circuit will be activated, then the heat of the processor will be reduced, sir. By the condition, heat will be main causes to destroy the processor chips. That's okay, why it will...
good. Are you writing any paper for your project? What is the status?
Almost it completed, sir.
Okay, good. So good Viva, good presentation, good work. I hope you complete your paper very soon and publish it. And yes. Thank you for participating, and all yes, the sir. Best for your career too. All the best. Thank you.
Thank you, first of all, and good morning for the respected people who are presented here. And this is Avinash Reddy Bhavanam, and we have done a project entitled Development of Automated Drip Irrigation System through Cloud Monitoring and Web of Things Technology. And this project is done under the guidance of Ms. K. Pamani Madam, and also I want to thank our principal sir and also HOD sir for this wonderful support. So without their support, we can't achieve this also. And our teammates are Konika Das, Agnesh Free, and Pavan Sai. And these are the present active team members. And also a few other team members are there, like Trinath, Bhargav Raj, and also. And so...
Okay, thank you. Suvarna Raju, sir, will ask you the Viva questions.
Thank you, sir. In your project, you have been using an Node MCU driver.
Node MCU modules.
Isn't it? I'm not sure. Node MCU. What is the difference between the ordinary driver and a Node MCU driver?
So basically, our ordinary modules are unavailable to connect with the internet. So basically, there is no specific hardware for connecting through the internet. But when it comes to the Node MCU, so we have a dedicated hardware part which is useful to connect with the internet access. So the device itself connect with internet. So without any external modules. So when it if you use, instead of this Node MCU, if you use Arduino board, then we need to attach a separate module to connect with the internet. So that's why we opted for Node MCU.
Okay, you have mentioned as an web of technologies in your project.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, what is the difference between the Internet of Things and Web of Things?
So, there is no difference between Web of Things and Internet of IoT, Internet of Things. So, just okay. We want to give a different name for that. So that's why we chosen Web of Things. So like nowadays, IoT is virally used, and many of the people are using that. So to give a different look for our project and to attract. Towards our project, we opted for Web of Things technology award.
Okay. with the use of internet, we can do a number of tasks, works.
Yes, sir.
And field. Yes, sir. Now, what are the works have been implemented by your project? Outline.
So the prime motto of our project is to automate the system, like to reduce the mechanical and financial burden on the farmers. But we can do some other things with the help of this project. We can create a database with the help of this system, and which is useful for the development of AI and machine learning based systems in future in the agriculture sector also. And also we can continuously monitor like wherever in the world. So the current some situations like nowadays the corona is happening here. So in such situations, some people are stuck in the red zones also. So those people cannot move towards their fields, or like they cannot go for the fields. So in such cases, these systems are very much useful for the farmers.
Okay. Now, so can you extend some parameters for a project?
So like
because of rain, so much farmers losing the crops. Heavy rains.
Okay.
Can you put in a shelter?
So that is it is possible with this system, sir. Like by adding an extension, like we can add that shelter part also by extension of this project, by like as an extension of this project. But we can do one thing also here. So we can measure the rain quantity, like how much rainfall is occurred in particular location. We can do with the help of this device, like at the field, how much rainfall is occurred. We can measure this.
Okay. And your project may be helpful for our Indian agriculture system.
Yes, sir.
As so
the program called Peer Drop More Crop. The program is this is an under researched program. Like the program is currently under processing. Like they are planning to implement this program by Indian government, and our project is mostly related for this this part of the project. Like the Peer Drop and More Crop. This is a title of the project, which is which is going to be implemented by the government. And when we send our project details to the officials, and they recognize that this project, like our project, is closely related for that research purpose.
Okay. And your project has been called by an ICT New Delhi.
Yes, sir.
They're asking that to implement that system on their land, field lands.
Yes, sir.
Type of works can be implemented by your project at Delhi in their field land?
Can other students also be asked?
Sir, at the Delhi or etc. So they are well known about the drip irrigation system. When it comes to their part, just we want to give the technical details and how we are going to implement the system with efficiently. So that is the main part we want to focus. So when we are going to give a demonstration at the AICT or some other part, because they know what is the drip irrigation system and rather than us, they know very pretty well than us, but they don't know the technical terms like electrical and electronic terminology, and also the part of the system, which is the circuits, etc. They don't know. So we want to mainly focus upon that part, and we want to convince them. We want to impress them with our work. Then they will definitely accept our project.
Okay. Recently, that CM Sir Jagangar has been announced that they have been investing in 100 crores of money for cultivation of an turmeric projects at Arku. Can we use your project in that fields?
Yes, sir. Like we have designed this project not for a particular purpose. Depending on the user's requirement, we can customize this in n number of ways. Which can be used by any kind of farmers and any kind of land.
Okay. Anyone can ask the questions for Avinash Reddy regarding this project?
No, Mr. Suvarnaraju, can you ask the other students? Can you ask the other three students?
Okay, sir. Konkadas.
Lohit, can you please put up their presentation slide, their circuit diagram?
Sir,
yes.
Like I will share my screen.
Sir, Amesh just said share his screen only.
Sir, I will share my screen.
Okay. Sir, please pose your question to the other team members.
Okay.
Sir. this is the log diagram of our project. And my team members, can you please proceed with them?
Next is our Konkadas.
Yes, sir.
Okay, how you transfer the information to from your mobile to an Node MU processor?
Node processor to connect to the inner, we'll be using Wi-Fi router, sir, and also in the smartphone and Android application will be installed, which will send this information to the cloud. And because the modem is connected to the internet by the Wi-Fi router, it accesses the information from the cloud.
Okay, the Node MU processor itself controls the release of the motors. Hello.
Yes,
okay, it can fill the tank, water tank, by using a programming language, by sending a message to the processor. Hello.
Sorry for the inconvenience.
Okay.
Please ask Agnes Puri
also. Agnes Puri. Agnes Puri.
Sir.
Can your project can test the moisture of the soil in the field?
No, sir. It cannot test moisture of the project, sir, of the soil, sir. But it can work on weather conditions, sir. If it's raining or cloudy, it will not work, sir. It will stop watering for the surface.
Okay. When we making watering, supply water to the field, at some edge it will be as less water, and at some edge it has more water. How do we can equate?
Sir, actually we are assigning time, sir.
What?
We are assigning some particular time for the pipes, for the valves and all. If we assign for 1 hour to fill this space, it will continue to work for that 1 hour, and later it will move on to the next valve, sir.
Okay.
Agneshwari, one second.
Sir.
Except Agneshwari, please mute all once. So otherwise, it is very hard to record it. Please mute all. Except Agneshwari as well as Sovanra sir, please mute yourself.
Okay, Pawan Sai, question to Pawan Sai. Sovanra sir, question to Pawan Sai. Let us conclude. Please unmute yourself, sir. Let us conclude. Please question to Pawan Sai.
Pawan Sai.
Sir.
What is your future extension of your project?
Sir, the future extension of the project is we are trying to connect with AI and artificial intelligence, sir, to water the field by their own. And also we are planning to connect with weather monitoring, sir. So at a certain place the weather was rainy, then the watering of the field will not be allowed to water, sir.
Okay, it has to give an alert to farmer that whether it having a cyclone, if there is a cyclone in that area.
Yes sir. So that
he can save some crop by doing something.
So by using the radar stations, they are indicating that the weather, if there is any cyclone, they are trying to send information to the weather monitoring system. So by that we can know that here that particular place the cyclone having at that place. By that the farmer can save the field, sir. Save the crop.
Okay, I'm back to Avnash.
That's it.
Conclude once about the project.
So in future we are going to extend, like we can extend this project depending on the requirements of the farmer. So in India, so all the farmers are not pretty well with the same amount, same problems, and also their needs, they're not they don't need all the needs provided by the governments, like in our like considering in our Andhra Pradesh areas. So some areas are having a well watered and some are not watered, like they are not having a sufficient amount of waters. So in such cases we can customize this project according to their requirements. So and also this project varies from crops like commercial crops and food crops. So commercial crops like some chilies and etc., cotton etc., so this system will be special, like the programming should be changed. And also for food crops like some mango and fruits like mango etc. etc., and food crops like paddy, we can customize this system according to that. And with this like if we get any support from the government or any other research institutes or officials, so we are going to implement this in full scale. And also we our main target is to make this system weather dependent, and also introduce the AI or machine learning technology to the agriculture, Indian agriculture system. So when we observe the foreign foreign agriculture systems etc., so they are using heavy equipments and also cultivating in a huge amount of lands, but when it comes to India, so our land is irregular, and also we are we are doing agriculture in a small scales. So we can overcome not full problems, but at some amount of problems we can overcome these. So that's why we hope that we will get some sort of support, like financial support, then we will implement we will take forward this project.
Okay, thank you, and congrats once again to all the members, because your project has been selected for ACTE New Delhi and win a good prize, and they are asking to implement one project at their bhavan and the fields. Okay, yes, by doing your hard work, you achieve your goal.
Okay, sir. And before closing, I want a special thank to our HOD sir, because so without his support we can't achieve this. He noticed our talent, but so he helped us. He spent a lot of time for us during night times also. He stood for 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock with us, and helped a lot. Especially thank you, sir, once again.
Thank you very much. So that concludes your final year project, Vivas. You all have done very good job. My hearty congratulations to you. It is a great joy that our principal, beloved principal, sir, is also with us, listening and participating in our meeting. And he is closely following your presentations. I'm not sure if he is available to speak, but sir, can you please give your concluding remarks? I'm not sure if he is in a position to speak right now.
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Francis, sir. Francis, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, you have. Thank you for your participation, sir. We have concluded our projects. Can you please give your concluding remarks to our students?
Yes, sir. Do you able to hear my voice?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Students, can you hear sir's voice?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good, good.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
As for my observation is concerned, you are well equipped. Whatever the basics you learn, based on the basics, you are developing very nice projects. Anyhow, in this difficult situation, you are connected through Zoom. I am very happy to see you all, and also see you all the HOD and all the faculty members. Good. My suggestion is, whatever the project you have, whenever you are going to any interviews, they will ask you many questions based on your projects. So be thorough of it, and this will be helpful and fetching for your career. Good. All the best. God bless you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Okay, students, This is your last engagement with the institute, academic engagement. So you have done very good job, and wish you a very best in all your career and your life. Thank you. You may leave the meeting.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.